do this with them, do that with them. And that the issue of percentage that we're talking about, and I doubt it even if the federal government or any state government will bring to an after they sign this agreement, will come to implement anything that is close to it. But I know the agreement is ongoing. My own conclusion is that most of the time when they say it's signed, it's because they want to bring people back. So that next 2 years, at least they will have a peace of 2 years. And then in 2 years, we can come back to you. Is that the solution? Are you proud that yes, I got something out of them for this 2 years? Even when you know that the next 2 years probably what can't you win this time? Why can't the union ask for its members? Are you teaching? Are you doing the right thing? As we fight for the welfare, we must also be disciplined. We know the vision of this polytechnic. Every member must subject themselves to the vision of the polytechnic. Ask questions of them. I have to stop for 10 people. Please, come be on standing. An applause until when you take your seat. You will be seated, please. The chairman of government council, sir. Very distinguished. Very distinguished ladies and gentlemen. The prayer at most times may the cost of education about to pay in Nigeria. That was the professor Abdullahi Nala, fourth chancellor of Kwara State University, Maliti, Kwara State, Nigeria. The chairman, sir, before I give you the mic, according to the Guinness Book of Record, the longest applause was 2 hours 32 seconds. So I know you have to do that, we'll be here till 3 o'clock. But time is not outside. But I want to clap in, and I want to suggest one which I will give to him. The first one is the ring job clapping, the second one is locomotive. So which one do you want me to give to him? Locomotive. I want to request that the clapping will go by the degree of my hand. The way I clap, the degree of movement is the way you are going to clap to. Please clap. And you may get it. Thank you. And thank you, sir. Once again, we want to appreciate you, sir. Professor Rashidala, Dr. Cooperative Literature, who has been described as an elder scholar in Colossus, in University is a well knowledge. I'm sorry, my chairman, let me say that in my 200 level, though we knew each other unofficially, internally, before I went to Unilog, he was my lecturer in oral literature. I know he has very good friend here. Mr. Jamiru is here. Mr. Jamiru Salamade is here. Mrs. Olatunwa Pintos. And several of them, Mr. Jai. Any of us going through him, who love his family, who are very close to him. And some of the things we do today, we want to appreciate you so much, sir. Thank you. Thank you. The council chairman, sir.
We will use the next 30 to 45 minutes for our engagement with the distinguished lecturer today, Professor Abdullahi Nala, Vice Chancellor of Kwara State University, Maliti. This has been a very incisive, very educative, very enlightening, and very challenging lecture in itself. And I hope to many of us here are particularly induced by my death. He says that for the last 4 years, he has never received any kind of subvention from the government, and yet he runs an institution of higher learning where lecturers' demands keep rising, where infrastructure demands keep rising, where non-academic staff demands keep rising. I am impressed, deeply impressed, by this. And perhaps I will be asking the rector to send our director of Poly Council and the Regression Director to your institution to speak about the facts. Is there about the book to understand certain things that you do there that you are able to run your institution on subventionless status? So that the person can start saying that it's money instead of no money. Having said that, let's not put up this. I'm with strong words to be able to understand the dynamics there. So, but for now, let's not put up this question. I would like you to, when you introduce yourself, be fast about that, and then let's avoid commentary. Just get straight to the question, and then we will take. Maybe the three questions you would have found that will get back to you. I know that the WAC was copiously noting some of the points that our distinguished lecturer did give out during this lecture. And I will send the microphone to him for the first question he has, WAC. I pray you to stand on this protocol. Actually, I am very, very close to the books. I am very, very close to Unilori and anybody close to Adekima. I don't have anything to say that tell him I don't expect anything short of what he said. But to block is during your lecture, you by direct or indirect way made reference to value orientation to staff. And the staff is not only put here today, all the institutions in the country, how do you know about that to achieve it? Thank you.
Okay. Who else would want to? Okay. Okay, madam.
Okay, you have to go to the question.
Okay.
Okay. Okay. Okay. Okay. Okay. Okay. Okay. Okay.
Okay. Okay. Okay.
Okay. Okay. Okay. Okay. Okay.
Okay. Okay. Okay. Okay. Okay. Okay. Okay. As to the way selection is being done, I didn't put that, but I realized while the fact that if you have a particular percentage, maybe 200 above, you go to the university. If you have less than 200, I think 200 to 150, you go to the university. And if you have less than 150, you go to the task training. From the beginning, there is a problem. And this started far back as when the problem of my daughter was started in the 70s. I was a secondary student. If you are in the first attempt position, they will tell you the secondary student. If you are in the 10th, 11th, 20th, they will tell you because you are 35 in the class. if they are not below, then you go to by water or the tap in you. So this does not bring down the people who are committed to teaching and lecturing to come and work as teachers and lecturers. People are just coming to teach and lecture as the last option, which is something the government needs to correct. And I think there is an emergency in that area. I have so many things I will discuss with the president.
And let me set the rules again. The council members, I can set the rules for them. Because you know there's a provision in the act that says that if your council members think that you are no longer working with the chairman, they can put amongst themselves and tell the minister to sack you. So I'm gonna set rules for them. Okay, I get to see the man who wrote that honorable council member or statement.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you, the chairman, for following me. Please, I stand on all the same protocol. I'm very grateful for the lecturer and the incisive lecture that given us today. It was purely a practical lecture, and this is the kind of things we need in Nigeria. Practical, go to the basic issues and not the arena. And from what you are saying, he identified that the major issue and ground within the emergency is in the system. The institutions are working, the systemic work of institutions. And he identified the management and the academy. And if you look at it, this points also now to the greater nation where these programs go back. When we were making efforts to elect the customer you have is the product of what comes from the attitude of the teachers. Okay? So my question is this. From this lecture, the point I gather is that there is need for reorientation of the system, of the people that work in the system. How do we guarantee this reorientation? Thank you, Mr. Lecturer.
Just before basically, is this along the same line? If it's not along the same line, because basically the two questions you have is along the same line. What you're about to say, is it along the same line? Okay.
All protocols duly observed. You have really made the point that the gospel has not passed. It's as well. On Sobio, Juman Latif Boye, Dean School of Environmental Studies, Laboratory. The research work done at the higher level, like PhD. There are those ones that are doing at the tertiary level, like Polytechnic. The purpose of research is to innovate, to produce new things for inflation, to better the life of the community, at the higher domain level, state and federal culture. But the university case is to dominate it. Now, and as a lecturer, if you are doing the right thing, I'm severe. I know what I so far as I did before I tell myself. No, it's basically practical. When you are supervising the project, and this student has not got it well, and then you need some student, and you are not a person that cannot make money like me, they tell you, that one is a scientist. Now, what are the measures that will be done by the institution that will enable them to cut all those from those lecturers that have been improving that performance, collecting money for research at the PhD level, and at the international level, what are the reasons that you think that people will increase that to take it not to take that? The performances. What are the reasons?
Can we get an answer here? Hello, can we get an answer here? Who will handle the microphone person, please? Okay? All right. Mr. Bushnitor.
Thank you so much for this opportunity to, you know,
address specific issues because I want to thank the MPC. You know, you will be the first person to ask his question, and especially to also, as kind as he's always been, he used his royal authority to support some of the things that I've said here. Thank you, sir. Well, I agree totally that the issue is about value orientation. We have misplaced our values. But the university system and that education system are supposed to be unique places where we make greater values and so on. That's why when we give certificates, especially in the university, we say it is for learning about character. Because value is important, certainly. It's important. It is wrong to give a person a certificate. Out of a university, at least, you know, that's what I am. But I hope it's also the same thing I'm protecting. If a person has degenerated in value system, because the certificate you are giving will be a wrong certification. So the issue is every national system must have a special project on value orientation. It is expected, especially because we have a general problem in Nigeria. Today, it's in our system we have autism. Today, in our system we kill people. I mean, when people kill people, we make our system. So, I totally agree with you that it's value orientation, but we need to address issues. I mean, I can tell you what we do in my university. Maybe the time I will explain it. Commitment of lecturers. And that it's actually a problem at the entrance level, which our mother has said. There are people who do not really qualify or who are not part of the high achieving students or candidates are those sent to be teachers. Maybe she's talking specifically of teachers, or maybe she's talking about all the other units. You see, as far as I'm concerned, I'm talking about not only teaching institutions. I'm not only talking about, you know, the university or the polytechnic alone. In the university system, we have a requirement. We don't have a 2-1. And you don't have a master's or PhD, you may not be in the university, you cannot be an academic. To become a professor, you must have done some work, right? Even if you, if some of them is fake, it is that you've done some work. And you have a 2-1. So you cannot, you can't have an excuse that the problem you have, you know, of lack of commitment is because you are choosing the professional education. You made a first class, 2-1, have a master, PhD. What other reason? And the types of students that are coming with you, that is why you are professional, that is why you are trained to help them. If they are poor students that are coming, how do you treat them? If you don't teach them, they come in, but you don't teach them, you don't go to classroom. I'm still just adding to the problems. Rather than mentoring them, helping them out. Even if you have to do some behavior work, it's your job to do. As long as they have been, you know, admitted into the institution, you have to try. I really don't agree that this is the same as anything to do with what I'm talking about. Maybe she's focusing more on the elementary school level. But even at that level, those who go for SC, because SC has the minimum required certificate at the elementary school. You know, they are supposed to have a certain number of credits. Each of orientation will come here. How do they get? They really get credit. Some of them will come with 5 credits, 6 credits, 7 credits. But at the end of the day, I understood that people help people to write these days. If that is true, all these credits, even those online credits who go to university and not to credit, they probably got someone to write for them. If that is the truth, then if she is sincere, she wrote it herself. I don't let God talk many of you and not to your day. She's not ready. She's probably ready to do a better work. It doesn't really matter in terms of. Well, the issue of the orientation. What I try to do for us as university is that we have no ambiguity about what it is we are about as a university. There's no ambiguity. We have to have a local standard. We have to have a local standard. And this is what we allow everybody to understand. In a very simple terms. A workers can ask is that there cannot be difference between what happened to university and the University of Illinois at the Harvard Champaign or Harvard University of Cambridge. If you are a lecturer in class and you are a lecturer there, you are supposed to compete. So if there are things happening there that should happen to the university. So you cannot give me a reason why you are not doing it in person. Simply because this is Nigeria. That cannot be a reason. After all, universities with masality. So our value has to align with the value of national education all over the world. Okay? You have to treat young people well. I gave an example of the way we treat our students as if they are slaves. A student comes to you, they have problems. You just shout at them, get out of my office. I mean, for God's sake,